Hi, everybody. I'm Miss Lora from the Lake Villa District Library, and welcome back to another Family Storytime. Today, we're going to read some books, sing some songs, and have a family dance party break. But we're going to start all of it with what I start all of my story times with. It's called These Are My Glasses. I know you know it. So you're going to make two circles with your hands and pretend they're your glasses, like this. And you're going to say, these are my glasses. This is my book. I put on my glasses and I open up the book and I read, read, read. And I look, look, look. I put down my glasses and I close up the book. Okay, you ready to sing with me? Wonderful. You got your glasses on? Here we go. These are my glasses. This is my book. I put on my glasses and open up the book. Now I read, 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 and I look, look, look. I put down my glasses and close up the book. Woohoo! You ready for a story? I have three different stories to share with you today. We're going to start with this one back here. This one is called Duckie's Ducklings. And what do ducks say, may I ask? Do you know? Yeah, they go quack, quack, quack. So this is called Duckie's Ducklings, a 1 to 10 counting book. And it's written and illustrated by Francis Berry. Okay, I'm going to read this today with permission from Candlewick Press. So let me get situated here so you can see the pictures. There's Duckie. Duckie was ready to take her ducklings for a swim. She looked around, but she could not find them. Well, that's a problem. She searched by the shed, but she found only flower pots. She looked below the apple tree, but she saw only apples. Near the roses, Duckie found only butterflies. There were no ducklings on the swing. Or under the cabbages. Where did those ducklings go? Or by the tomatoes? So Duckie waddled on. Have you been looking really closely at the pictures? Do you see what I see? Right here. She looked among the sunflowers. Peered behind the trees. And peeked among the strawberries, but she didn't see her ducklings. Where are they? Then Duckie heard a tiny quack. She turned around. There they were! 10 little ducklings all ready. Can you count to 10 with me? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Show me all 10 fingers. Wiggle them, wiggle them, wiggle them. They were all ready for a swim. The end. And then in the back of this book, it shows you that we were counting other things along the way. So maybe you should check out this book and see what other things you can count. Duckie's Ducklings. Okay, you ready for another story? I'm really excited about this next one. It's called Lunch. I love lunch because I love food. Do you guys like food? This is called Lunch. It's written and illustrated by Denise Fleming. I'm going to read this today with permission from Henry Holt and Company. So we have our little mouse. Mouse was very hungry. He was so hungry. He ate a crisp white What is that? Turnip! Have you ever had a turnip before? Tasty orange. What is that? Yeah, carrots! Sweet yellow. What do you think that is? Corn! Yum, I love sweet corn. Tender green. What's next? Peas! I love peas. Peas are one of my daughter's favorite vegetables. Tart blue. What are those things? I know you know it. Berries, blueberries. Blueberries are my daughter's favorite fruit. Man, this book was made for her. Sour purple. Grapes. I like grapes. Shiny red. What is this big red thing? Apples. Man, our mouse is getting a good lunch, isn't he? And juicy pink. This might be my favorite. What is that? It's great in the summer. Watermelon! I love watermelon. Crunchy black seeds and all. I mean, I don't eat the seeds, but if Mouse wants to, go for it. Then, he took a nap. That's a good idea to do after lunch. Until dinner time. The end. And then at the last page, this is so great. We have a little diagram of how messy our mouse got. And you can see all the different things all over his body. Like he has green peas on his tail, and he has apples on his feet, and corn on his nose. He's just a mess, this mouse, but a happy mess. Lunch. Okay, I think it's time for a song. It's time for our family dance party break. So we're going to dance to a song called The Silly Dance Contest by Jim Gill. So you need to create room because we're going to be super silly and dance really crazy things. Grab your grown-ups and I'll see you in a second. Okay, I'm ready. Are you ready to dance to the Silly Dance Contest? The great thing about this song is Jim Gill is going to tell us how to dance, when to dance. So we just need to use our listening ears so we know what to do. Here we go.
Now this is called the Silly Dance Contest, where the silliest dancer is always the best.
Can you be the silliest?
You just dance, dance, dance as silly as you please, and when the music stops, then you freeze.
Yes.
Dance any way you want to, dance any way you please, dance any way you want to, but stop when I say freeze. Hold that freeze. As quiet as you can. And get ready for the Silly Dance Contest Round 2. Dance any way you want to. Dance any way you please. Dance any way you want to. But stop when I say freeze. Freeze. Like a statue. Now if you look silly, you're doing great.
You look silly.
And this time we're going to jump up and down as high as we can.
I'm gonna jump really high.
Jump as high as you want to, jump as high as you please, jump as high as you want to, but stop when I say freeze. Stay frozen.
Don't move! Stay frozen.
Some people freeze with a silly face. And this time, let's dance as fast as we can.
Fast.
Dance as fast as you want to, dance as fast as you please, dance as fast as you want to, but stop when I say freeze. I told you that was fast. But now here's the hard one. Dancing in slow motion.
Can you stay slow?
Dance as slow as you want to. Dance as slow as you please. Take a partner. Slow as you want to. One final round of the silly dance contest. Dance any way you want to. Dance any way you please. Dance any way you want to. Let's stop when I say freeze. And it ends with your arms stretched way up high in the air.
Way up high.
And when the music gets lower, everybody shrinks a little lower. And then lower. And lower. And lower.
Get all the way to the ground.
And all the way down.
See you for another story.
Wasn't that fun? I love Jim Gill. He's great with songs. You ready to read our last story? It's a shorter one. Some of the pages have no words at all. So we're gonna have to look at the pictures really closely. This is called Pignic. Kind of like a picnic that you would have in the spring or the summer, but with pigs. So a pignic. And it's written and illustrated by Matt Phelan. Let's see. I'm going to read this today with permission from HarperCollins, so thank you. Here our pigs go on a little picnic. It's a perfect day for a picnic. There is a tree to climb. Uh-oh, too high. So the turtle helped. Hooray! There is a kite to fly. What's sneaking up on them? Uh-oh, no wind. Except, what does that big bad wolf do in that story? He huffs and he puffs. Huffs and puffs, hooray! Look at that, he created the wind for us. Pretzels, pies, pickles, and plums. Look at all those P-word foods. That sounds delicious. Look at that, everyone is having a great time. Our wolf is flying the kite, they're rolling down the hill, running all over, eating some tasty food. Uh-oh, dark clouds. What does that mean? I think that means it might rain. I think you're right. You were right, look at that. That is not how I want to have a picnic. What are they going to do? Mud? Wait a second. Do pigs like mud? Mud! I think they do. Hooray! Hooray! What a perfect day for a picnic. The end. Pignic. Isn't that cute? I like that story. All right, well, this was a quick story time this week, but we have time for one last song. It's called Skinnamarink. It's how I end all of my story times. And you need your elbows. I know you have them. You're gonna hold one like this and wiggle those fingers, and then switch and wiggle those fingers. You ready to sing with me? Here we go. Skinnamarink-a-dink-a-dink, skinnamarink-a-doo, I love you. Skinnamarink-a-dink-a-dink, skinnamarink-a-doo, I love you. I love you in the morning and in the afternoon. I love you in the evening and underneath the moon. Oh, skinnamarink-a-dink-a-dink, skinnamarink-a-doo, I love you. Yay! Thanks so much for joining me for story time today. If you liked any of my books, be sure to put them on hold or come on in and check them out. And if you'd like to know any more about our programs, you can check that out on our website, www.lvdl.org, and head on over to the events calendar. See you next time.